Well, if you're about to head out the door with a mall as your mission, stand by. Before you purchase that designer dress, there are six questions you need to ask yourself to make sure it all looks good on you and on your bottom line. Adam Glassman is the creative director for Oprah Magazine, which breaks it all down for us. Adam, good morning.
Good morning.
So these six questions, I know O Magazine created this list, this go-to list, before you go out and purchase, before you run that credit card again. What are you hoping that people think of and ask themselves?
Well, I'm hoping that people really think about great buys and shopping with some smarts, really. Mm-hmm. You want to avoid impulse shopping, ultimately.
Tough economic times, tough market right now.
Very tough. And I think it's also very important to shop with a debit card or cash, not just a credit card.
So you're not telling women not to shop here, right?
Oh, no,
it's
no,
just
no, because
to be
shopping
smart about
is really
it.
Fun and enjoyable.
It's
and
retail therapy for a lot of women.
It is, but there are needs that we have and there are wants, so we really have to think about the two things.
Okay, first question that you say you should be asking yourself is, have I covered my basic monthly expenses? So we're talking about your mortgage, your rent, whatever it may be, you know,
all
the electricity.
Of that. Most important.
Okay.
That's the most important question. If you have any leftover money, then you could think about shopping.
But you do have to set aside, of course, your money for your savings and all of that.
Course,
but you're talking about discretionary money.
Correct. Okay. You don't want to buy a new Burberry trench before you pay your electric bill.
Cash or credit card? Any suggestion
cash.
There?
Cash or debit card. I think so. And go with the amount of money that you want to spend. If you want to spend $100, just bring the $100 with you.
Okay. Next, you say, is to look at the price. Obviously, looking for the lowest price possible, but you say there's a formula that you can follow to figure out if you're really getting your money's worth.
Yes, well, I love this formula. You look at the price of the garments, mm-hmm. and you think about the number of times you're going to wear it over a lifetime. Divide the two, and if it works out to about $3 or less per wear, it's a great buy. Buy it, hold on to it, wear it.
Getting a lot of wear for your buck then. You also
Correct.
Say before hitting the stores, ask yourself, do I really need this? I mean, this is the mistake that all of us follow. I mean, do we ask ourselves that question? Really, a lot of us don't. So what is the easiest way to determine what you really need versus what you want?
Well, you want to make a list, really. Yeah. You want to take stock of your closet, and you need to look and think about all the basics first. Mm-hmm. If you're missing a white shirt, add that to the list. If you're missing a black pant, add that to the list. Before you start buying a trendy item that will go out of style quicker than you could even probably wear it.
I think the mistake a lot of us make is we buy on impulse and we tend to buy things that sometimes we already have something very similar, right?
Correct.
Do we even know what we have in our closet half the time?
Well, I think about 20%. Most women really only wear 20% of mm-hmm. what they have in their closet. And you really want to buy stuff that works with other things you have. We've all made that mistake of, does it go and what do I do with it?
Okay, next thing is you really want to make sure that you ask the question, does this purchase, this dress or whatever I'm buying, suit my body? So important, the fit, right?
The most important thing, you want it to flatter your body. You want clothes that sort of play up your assets and downplay parts of your body that you want to perhaps camouflage. But you also want clothes that make you feel alive mm-hmm. and happy. So befriend your tailor, the most important thing. Mm-hmm. Find a tailor because everything needs a little nip and tuck.
So it should look like it was made to fit you.
Correct.
Okay, next you say the other important question is it comfortable and is it low maintenance? I mean, so there are certain fabrics that are going to allow that a little bit better than others.
Correct. And I have this test. You don't want fabrics that are going to wrinkle every time you wear it.
Right.
And which means you have to go to the dry cleaner every time you wear it because that adds to the cost of the garment. Just scrunch the clothing. When you're in the store, scrunch it. If it gets very wrinkly, avoid that piece of clothing.
Mm-hmm. And when it does say dry cleaner only, does that always mean that you have to take it to the dry cleaner?
I really do suggest it for the most part. I mean, some things can be hand washed, but you really want to find things that you don't have to dry clean all the time.
Another thing to consider is the longevity of the piece that you're buying. I mean, you say you really, if you want to get your money's worth, buy something that you think you're going to look good in maybe 10 years from now. Are we really buying purchases that are going to last us a lifetime?
Well, I think we should think like that.
Yes.
Because it is an investment. No matter what you spend, it is an investment. So great classics really last a lifetime. If you like it now when you're 40, are you going to like it on yourself when you're 50 or even 60?
All right, so words to live by, things for us to consider before we impulse buy. Adam Glassman, thanks so much.
Thank you.
I feel very guilty this morning.